All right, now it's been a while. We're going to take a look at a Genesis Mega Drive game. Yes, and it's a great one, which I'm sure quite many of you are probably familiar with. Fire Shark, also known as, and it's got a kind of a strange name in the Japanese version, Same, Same, Same. It's got to be one of the few times I actually don't prefer the alternate title to a game. I think Fire Shark is a lot cooler. Maybe it's just me. Anyway, it was developed by Toaplan and published by DreamWorks in North America anyway, but Toaplan published it themselves in Japan. This was originally an arcade game, and overall, things considered, this conversion is actually very well done. And it's got some fantastic music, and really it just hits all the points you want for a shooter. It doesn't have a huge amount of weapons and power-ups, but it doesn't really need it because, well, the weapons you get kind of upgrade themselves. You'll see what I mean. Anyway, there's a little bit of a story to this one that's kind of interesting, so I'll read it to you as I usually do. On an alternate Earth, heavy arms producing nation S-Corps starts invading other countries, and the Tiger Shark, a biplane, which is the one you use, the red one there, seems to be the only hope for stopping S-Corps. And that's really all the story there is to it. As with most shooters, it's very tissue paper thin, but you don't really need it. It's all about the gameplay here, and it's fantastic. And one other thing that's cool is this game has three different difficulties, easy, normal, and hard. Nothing special there. And one thing they did do, which is pretty cool, is there's a different ending depending on which difficulty you play on. The game, for whatever reason, this is not the only one that does this, defaults to easy, which even I don't like playing on that, so I'm going to jack it up to normal because that's what I'm used to in playing in this. So also, you notice it has a rapid-fire option. I won't be turning that on. Yes, as I mentioned before, I don't mind mashing buttons most of the time. All right, let's get to it. And as I do any time with shooters, kind of count this as my one credit high score, whatever I end up with. I was actually going to do this quite a while back, and I never did for some reason. The game's got fantastic music, though, like I said, as it's about to kick in. Listen to that. Now, this, unfortunately, is also one of those shooters where you really want to try your best to never die, because if you do, you lose your weapon upgrades, which sucks. As I said, there's not many of them, but they will upgrade and get more powerful and more useful. The one you really want is the red one, which you can just sweep the entire screen and it takes a lot less hits to kill anyone. Not only that, especially with bosses, because it's doing constant damage to the screen, you get a lot of points that way. Also, you don't have to mash the button. Whether or not you're bothered by mashing buttons, it's just more convenient that way. You just sweep the screen and it kills enemies really quick. It's very powerful. Many other ones have their uses. It's nice that for change, unlike most shooters, your default weapon here actually kind of starts off as a spread shot, so you can hit more than one enemy at a time. That is a very good thing. I like that about it. But you do want to replace it as soon as you can, and if you do die and you manage to still make it somehow, you want to replace it again. Like with this weapon, the green one. It makes an annoying sound, but it's much more powerful and useful. Although, as you notice, you lose the spread ability, so you gotta be on your toes. You do die in one hit in this, like always, but the thing in this is, a lot of times you'll not realize you've been hit, and unless you see that your plane's on fire, which is an indication you're about to blow up, so, it's one of those things you gotta be careful with. In terms of difficulty and shooters and all that, this one's very well balanced. It's not unfair. There are certain parts where it can get really ridiculous, but at no point are you really gonna feel like the game's cheating you. And here's the red beam I was talking about. This is easily the best weapon. And again, you don't have to mash the button to use it, which is fantastic. Just sweep the screen, it kills everyone. Eventually, you'll get the much higher upgraded version, which you see on the demo screen before I started. And I already have two streams, which is fantastic. And once you get the kind of spider-webbing legs going on with this, then it'll actually move around and you can shoot behind you. Until then, you kind of have to deal with it as it is. Almost through the first stage here, too. It's just a very awesome shooter. I've always really liked it. The arcade version's great, too. Again, it's pretty much exactly the same as this. They did a very, very good job on the conversion. There's a bomb pickup. You don't see those that often. You really want to save those for bosses. I know I say that all the time when I do videos on shooters, but it really is true for this game. Now, look at the score as I'm shooting here. You notice that I'm constantly getting score as I'm hitting it with this thing. Like I said, that's the best thing about this weapon, beyond just how powerful it is. The unfortunate thing is if you do die and you have to get it again, it doesn't really appear as frequently as some of the other ones. Like the green one. My recommendation, if you see it, go for it. It's so useful. Then it's just nice to kind of be on cruise control and not have to mash the button all the time. Even though I kind of like mashing the button, even I'll say that sometimes I don't feel like it. And there's the first stage done. What's kind of funny is every time you're done a stage, you go to the runway here and you take off again. In one of them later on, you're going to see that there's someone else who tries to take off, only they kind of suck at planes and they crash. It's funny. Smack right into the wall. I love it. All this talking I'm doing, I really got to concentrate so I don't die here. Power up. Yes. You also want to collect all these little lightning bolts, which are hidden most of the time in buildings, and sometimes enemies drop them. It's kind of like if you ever played Metal Slug and how you rescue the POWs. If you actually survive to the end of the stage and you'll die and have to come back, you'll get a very nice bonus for doing so. Which you kind of already saw I did when I ended the last stage. Just saying. You really want to try and collect these lightning bolts as much as you can. I don't need to say that if it puts your ass in danger, you shouldn't. Now here's the unfortunate thing. You're going to see these powers bouncing around. If you really don't want one, you got to try your best to avoid it. And sometimes you're going to be put in danger's way to avoid it. Kind of sucks. But that's just how it goes. Sometimes. In shooters. At one point, you're going to see a whole lot of these blue things bouncing around. And I try to avoid them. It doesn't always work. Unfortunately, I might be forced to take it. As much as I don't want it. I didn't want to use bombs back there, but it's better safe than sorry. That's what I say. I'm not the greatest at this, but better than some other shooters. Which is strange how that works, I think. And I just got a bomb back. Now this is actually one of my favorite stages, because all the ships and all that you have to fight. Unlike a few other games I can think of where you fight ships, this one's a little bit more less ridiculous. Especially when it comes to the big ship you have to fight. There's a couple of them. If you have at least one bomb at that point, you'll be fine. Although, if you have this weapon, again, you're kind of safe, too. Now, here's another good thing about this weapon, is you can go right up to these guys, and you can kill them, and they won't really do anything to you, most of the time. Once in a great while, I've seen that they actually can hit me. When I pull that trick off, it's kind of a little risky. And now I gotta watch out that I don't accidentally get shot down, or pick up that blue thing, because I don't want it. Ooh, I also don't want to get crashed into. And I didn't miss the lightning bolt, which is good. The red turrets always drop the red ones. And now I have the next level of the attack, and you can see it gyrates around there. It's like I got spider legs. This is the level you really want, because, well, just look at it. It covers the entire screen. It's fantastic. Unfortunately, I have no more bombs, so I'm all on my own. Hoo-haw. And I still get that lightning bolt. Fantastic. Oh man, I was a little worried there for a second. But the stage is not over yet, unfortunately. Now it is. And if I remember right, this is the one where the guy is a failure to try and lift off. I played Flight Simulator a lot of times. I kind of have an idea what he might have done wrong. Yep, he's gonna hit the wall. Lip, pull up. What's wrong with you? I like that. There's a little bit of humor in this. Alright, now this is the stage where you fight the big ship I was kind of referring to. The last one just basically introduced the little ships. But so long as I have this level of the weapon, I'll be fine. Not to say that mess-ups don't happen. Also, more lightning bolts. You also get some points when you pick them up, but you get the most at the end bonuses. The faster you get through a stage, the better, too. There's all different factors, of course, as always with this. I don't really have anything else I can say, if you can't tell. It's just an absolute fantastic shooter, and I highly recommend it. Or playing the arcade version as well. Play both. Like I said, this is an extremely good conversion overall. Probably the best they could pull off, without a doubt. Compared to some other ones I know of. Like DJ Boy. Ugh. Alright, now I gotta really watch for all these things. Look at them all flying around. Trying to avoid these things. Oh, yep. And that's what happened. Oh well, I'll just get a lot of points. And I died, predictably. Yeah, that was all me, but I tried to avoid picking up certain items and it didn't work. Now, here's something that is kind of convenient. I did die when I did, so now I can explain this thing. When you do die, it doesn't punish you by making you redo the entire stage over. Instead, it kind of, wherever you are, it has predetermined checkpoints. In case in point, where I am here, it actually moved me up further than where I was. So it's almost like the game wanted to cheat itself by making me not go through that again. It's kind of strange, but it's how it works. It's much more fair to some other games. I mean, let's be honest, who likes replaying in a shooter the beginning of the first stage you were on again and again and again? Like I said, ideally this game gives you everything you could want in a shooter, at least from the 16-bit era. I don't really have any complaints with it myself. I love it. It's fantastic. I like the whole kind of blend of... Oh, that was me again. I like the whole blend of somewhat part futuristic and part old technology, too. It's something that Compile did a lot in their shooters. One of the reasons I like theirs a lot. Toaplan made a lot of great games, though. This is just another example of that. And fortunately, a very, very good port from the arcade, which those don't always work out. Alright, so here's the big ship. I messed up twice there, which I shouldn't have. I feel bad about that, but accidents happen, like I said. Give me that lightning bolt. I'm gonna try to hold it together here so I can at least make it to the end of this one. So many planes. I've already passed the qualification for an A, so they need to make a new rank at this point, I think. Well, you can see right here what I mean by how your default weapon, even though it's very weak and sucks and it's not that fast, it's still useful, unlike some other games, because it has that spread shot you just saw right there, a perfect example of it. Score's alright, too. I've gotten better at this point, but whatever. There we go, that helps. And an extra life. So we're gonna keep going. Go until I run out of lives, as usual. And now we're kind of in a place much like the first stage. Although, at least now I can actually get some kind of an upgrade. Not a weapon, though, unfortunately. I love the green... Oh. There's a case of me not seeing the little shots again. I'm falling apart here. And it was about time that would happen. I'm talking a lot, what can I say? Whoa. You gotta watch out for that. They crash into you. I hate that worse than being shot down. I've mentioned that before, too. Rather die from a shot I should've and could've missed, but didn't see for some reason, than get crashed into. Oh, kinda like that. I should've used the bomb, but I didn't want to. Oh well. Alright, I'm on my last life now. Maybe I should use it. And I thought I could handle it. I overestimated. There we go. And give me something good. Well, it's not great, but I'll take it. Now my default shot's more powerful. I'll take what I can get. Including that. But you can see what I mean, what I said earlier about how the red beam doesn't appear a lot. I haven't seen it since I first got it. Take these tanks out. Good. Enemy variety, I know I'm a little late mentioning this, but enemy variety in this is pretty much all the same kind of stuff. There's boats, there's planes, there's tank-looking things. But they change what they look like enough that you're not really going to get bored looking at them. It's the best way I could put it. Compared to some other shooters I can think of, again, to be fair, it has more variety in that regard. So it's got that going for it as well. Yeah, got it. Alright, I gotta get that. There we go. Yes, I lost my spread, but at least now I can kill things quicker. And that's what matters. Oh, and look, I have the red shot back again because I already had the S power upgrade. I have the two beams again. So I've kind of got myself back up mostly to where I was before I absolutely ruined it all. Another thing I like about this game, you can rebound in it much better than you can in some other ones. Even your default speed you move at is pretty good. Yes. Give me those lightning bolts. I want all the points. I got a bad feeling it might end right here. It's these little shots I'm worried about. Come on, I can do it. It's on fire, which is a good sign. Yeah, I got it. It's kind of an odd looking tank too. Whoa, I thought I was going to get hit right there. You saw how close that was. Good thing once in a while my reaction times actually pay off. And another stage down. And, well, we're going to keep going. I'm on my last life, so can't imagine it's going to go that much longer. See, now, that guy in that plane that failed earlier to pull up, he should have went here, because he's got no huge walls to worry about, although he could have still crashed. I just realized that. Clearly, they were taking anyone that day when they were giving out pilot licenses, and, well, during the war effort, you know, you'll take what you can get. Apparently. That's what I'm going with in this. Yes. I think this game would have been even cooler if it had the kind of a counter like it does in 1942, 1943, how many enemies you've taken out, but it doesn't. Or Afterburner, it doesn't that too. Whoa, that was close. Yes! Now we're talking. Now I'm a force to be reckoned with. The funny thing is, when I first played Fire Shark, I always thought when you have this, it's next impossible to get killed. Oh no, it is. Especially if you downgrade yourself to a different weapon. I consider it a downgrade if you have anything but this weapon, but that's just me. Oh, speaking of which, here we go again. I gotta jump around all over the place to try and avoid picking them up. If I had any complaints with the game, it's this. The power-ups should just go away and not do this. At the same time, though, you could say it's better than what some games do, where they disappear so quick you don't have a chance to get them. So, have them linger or have them around forever. Wow, I can't believe I actually got that and not the blue thing. The other one's gone, now let's... Yep, there it goes. Alright, I'm good. I don't want to lose this again. Last time I lost it, it got me killed. Although, I will say, I'm surprised you're still going here. Hey, I'm fine with that. That just means I'm going to have a better score. Oh yeah. 2-for-1 video. Then you guys get to see more of the game. I actually practice on hard, but I'm better normal when I go for doing something like this. But easy at defaults too. Nah, it's too easy, even for me. Another little recommendation I have for you playing this. Bump it up to at least normal. Alright, here we go again. Well, that made quick work of him. I should have kind of let him stay alive a little bit longer, even though it put myself at risk so that I can grind him for a score. I just blast him with my proton stream here. Ghostbusters in the air. And that song crescendoed crazily. Again, I love the soundtrack in this. And should be near the end of the stage sometime soon here. It's kind of strange how quick you can take out that guy. Compared to some of the other bosses, that one really doesn't take much punishment. I don't know why. I wouldn't say this shooter is like some other ones where the whole game is very hard, where the bosses are absolutely embarrassingly easy. Some of the bosses are tricky. But that one, for whatever reason, if you just have two bombs and you have this weapon, that's nothing. It makes extremely quick work of them. Oh, here we go again. I gotta both dodge their shots, dodge crashing into them, and avoid picking up something. It's like if you're playing a Sonic or a Mario game and you don't want to collect coins or rings. Seems kind of strange. But I'm doing this for good reason. That one disappeared quick. Oh, and I just got an extra life. Damn. Oh well. Well, I can't see this is going to go on much longer. Although I have bombs, so who knows. I think use them up on these things because I can't do enough damage to them. Ah, didn't give me a weapon. It's alright, I'll try and make do without. I have one more bomb. I gotta be very, very particular when I use it, though. Come on, give me something good. It's okay, but it's not great. Can I get it without killing myself is the question. Yeah, there we go. I didn't think the bomb was gonna reach, but it did. I'm alive for a little bit longer. Oh, maybe not much longer. Two of them at the same time. Oh wait, a bomb. Can I get it? Yeah, I got it. I'm amazed how well I'm doing right now just with the normal weapon. Even this late in the game. Oh, I took a few more with me for score. Yeah, I like my score, but there you go. Kind of a long look at Fire Shark, also in the same for the Genesis Mega Drive, as well as my final score there. So, there you go. That's it. Again, highly recommend the game or playing the arcade version. Both are great. So, that is it. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later.